Blackstone presents Toil and Trouble, A Women's History of the Occult by Lisa Kröger and Melanie R. Anderson. This book is read by Tegan Ashton Cohan. For everyone who dares to be 100% that witch. Introduction. In July 2020, at a time when we arguably did not need more problems, a group of young witches tried to hex the moon. It doesn't really matter why, or whether they were successful. The moon's still here, so maybe not. In fact, it's not clear how many people were involved or how serious they were. People outside the online occult community found out about the event through social media posts about what the so-called baby witches were planning and why it was a bad idea, and through a cascade of news stories about the rumor on sites like BuzzFeed. That doesn't really matter either. What's important is that there's an online occult community at all. And not only that, but a community so robust and popular that it is able to sustain fringe groups, like the witches who hexed the moon, and warring factions, like the people who suggested that maybe they shouldn't. What's also important is that all of this happened in public. This would have been unthinkable to women in 17th century New England, even if they could get past the idea of the internet. Witch used to be an accusation with potentially fatal consequences, not an identity to proudly display and endlessly debate in the public square. Those long-ago women might be similarly shocked by the recent popularity of crystals, tarot cards, and astrology memes. In an age of uncertainty, dislocation, and environmental turmoil, younger generations are taking a renewed interest in astrology, horoscopes, and the occult, wrote Josh Walker in a 2020 Wired article. That renewed interest is more like a tidal wave. On the social video app TikTok, which is popular with people in their teens and 20s, the hashtag WitchTok garnered more than 2 billion views in 2019 and 2020. Driving those views were videos offering everything from good luck spells to protection potions. In other words, predictability in times of uncertainty. After all, young adults in 2020 were getting ready to enter the world in scary times. Economic downturn, a terrible job market, political uncertainty, public protests, and a pandemic raging out of control. But it's more than just difficult times that are responsible for young people's, especially young women's, interest in the occult. From the start of the United States, whose colonial period coincided with the violent witch hunts in Europe of the 16th and 17th centuries, women have had a close relationship with the occult. At times, whether they wanted one or not. Over the years, women have been variously cast as unnatural, supernatural, angelic, demonic, attuned to death, or in league with the devil. So, how did we get from Salem to today's proud witches? Centuries of women responded to these accusations by using the occult as a route to power. When we started working on this book, we wanted to investigate all the ways women interacted with and used occult tools to achieve empowerment. We published our first book, Monster, She Wrote, in the fall of 2019. As we started thinking about our next project, we began exploring the ways women's history and the history of the occult intersected. Specifically, we were interested in examining women's occult history in the United States. While we were having these conversations in 2020, our focus kept being pulled toward world events. We won't go into everything here, we all lived through it, but what was fascinating to us was how much the occult was a constant presence. Women everywhere, it seemed, were responding to the pandemic and to the political upheaval of the impending election with what appeared to be a witchy attitude. Women on TikTok were explaining how to hex Trump, something that, we learned, witches had been doing since his election in 2016. Witches on Instagram were posting...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.